it just goes to show, you know, one person can have an idea and you never know where it's going to take you. I am a local resident from Wabaca, Wisconsin, birthplace of Flag Day. Another local here was Bernard Sigrund. He was a teacher, and that was in 1885. One of the things he had his students do was he put this bottle on the desk, put a flag in the bottle, and he had them write an essay, what the flag means to me. He also was a World War I vet, and when he came back, he pursued his love of the flag and wanted to make sure it was a special event.
He spoke to anybody that would listen, and he wrote articles in any periodical that would publish them. He finally had an audience with President Wilson, Woodrow Wilson, and Woodrow Wilson listened to him. And it was that president that declared June 14th as Flag Day. In 2004, there was a resolution in Congress that actually makes Wabaca the official birthplace of Flag Day.
Because Stony Hill School is the birthplace of Flag Day, we honor it annually with a celebration of Flag Day here at the schoolhouse. And this year it's going to be on June 15th. And we have the American Spirit Singers singing the national anthem. We have the Saukville American Legion who will raise the flag and teach the crowd about flag etiquette. And then we also have the 132nd U.S. Army Reserve Band that will play patriotic songs.
I think you'd be very impressed with the Acuity flag. And that we still continue to recognize Flag Day and all the things that he started.
I think he would go, wow. I really do, because I go, wow, every time I see it. But I also think he would say, it doesn't matter if it's a flag in an inkwell on a desk, you know, 3 inches, or the Acuity flag. I think he would say, there it is. As long as we keep that drive alive and that spirit alive, and there's enough people in the United States and in Wisconsin and in Will Wabaca in particular, I think it will always survive. As long as that thing is flying, I know we're still the United States of America.